soundcheck. 1, 2, 3, soundcheck.
Yeah.
And it's the same old town, still like top. Went to a day in the mid. Never lost all the suits, you shot me in the car. It's the same way it was. That you will, but I know they can't come this way. No, I know they can't come this way.
You need a little more gain from my guitar, you know, right?
It's all good. I've seen the world as ugly as man. Looking at the backside of me. They sing my songs, and he's not gonna come. But everything ain't done this way. I know I don't think I ain't done this way. Oh,
yeah. You're good if you are. You need anything else? Go.
KSUZQ.com.
Okay. Y'all ready? 1, 2, 3, you're live.
Good evening, listeners. You are listening to KSUZQ.com. The Big Q. We are broadcasting live tonight from the Horny Toad Pub and Grub here in downtown Snyder, Texas, the famous square here in downtown Snyder, Texas. We've got a very, very special treat for you tonight. We've got Mr. Will Carter. How are you doing today?
Doing good. What's going on, y'all?
Oh, man, not much. Just excited to have you here. Really happy you came by Snyder. Now come to the Big Q to see us tonight.
Man, I'm pretty excited. This is the first on-air radio interview I've gotten to do in a live music venue. This is pretty cool.
Great.
This is
awesome. There you go.
Yeah, thanks again for having me, guys.
Well, we're glad to be your first live music venue to do an interview in, you know, you wouldn't expect that from a little town like Snyder, Texas, but, you know, we try to throw you a curveball every now and then.
I like it. I like it a lot.
Awesome. Well, you're here on a little radio tour, right?
That's right. We are currently in the second half of week two of a two-week radio tour. First we went to Southeast Texas down the Corpus Christi, Padre Island kind of area, and then we circled back up and hit Abilene, and here we are in the big town of Snyder.
There you go. Obviously promoting your new single, I Don't Know Why.
That's right.
That's the name of your single, I Don't Know Why.
We are promoting it, but that's correct.
You're right. Yes, very good. So tell us a little bit about yourself. Where are you from?
I'm from a small town just about 30 minutes west of Houston. Small town by the name of Seeley, and I can't even really say that actually. I'm from a suburb of Seeley. It's a very, very tiny community called Freedeck, which was home to about 300 people, and grew up real old-fashioned like. Had a garden and milked goats every morning and gathered eggs and had cows and horses and trained horses, and like I said, you know, it's basically a self-sustaining farm. And I was actually homeschooled until eighth grade. I lived out there. I had a 12,000-acre backyard. I was out there every single day with guns and horses and four-wheelers and that kind of thing. And then moved to Katy for high school and got the other side of the experience with graduating from a 5A high school in a bigger town, Katy. So got to see kind of both sides of the spectrum.
There you go. And you know, we see a lot of country music nowadays, Texas and Nashville, just, you know, all sorts, talking about growing up on farms, small town living. You really live that.
That's true, I do. I feel like I grew up a little differently than most of the people in my generation. Not a lot of people, my age, gathered like some notes, goats, and had a garden and kind of thing. So yeah, I would say that that's a little out of the norm for at least my generation.
Yeah. Yeah. So songwriting wise, how has it affected you?
Well, you know, it's made me flow around to it. You know, I have songs on the album that's coming out here pretty soon. They talk about how I grew up, you know, the younger years or whatever, and that like more old country style, and then moved to a bigger city, and then went to Texas A&M University after that, and you know, did the whole college thing, and so you see that kind of progression through the album. You see the song about kind of where I started, and then kind of where I went from there. You know?
Awesome. You know, talking about where you started from, I saw that, you know, at age 18, you were the lead singer of a band here in Texas.
That's right. The Emotions, they're a pretty legendary dancehall band. They've been around since the 80s. And growing up in the Sioux area where I did, they were a real big deal. You know, I follow everybody from about high school, junior high school age on. You know, for the past 30 years, I was kind of in that area. I've been following this band, and myself included. And so to be asked to be, and hired on as a lead vocalist for that band right out of high school. In fact, I got the offer 2 weeks before I graduated from Katy. And to have that opportunity was a huge honor for me, and it was super cool, obviously. But also, you know, I learned a lot from it. Getting to tour around the state of Texas, they got an 18-wheeler with big sound, big lights, big production, real high energy live show, wireless guitar pickups and wireless in-ear monitors and wireless headset and microphone at the time and stuff. So that taught me a lot about how to throw a real high energy live show, which is another real important piece of the whole live music kind of puzzle. You know?
So you've obviously, you've got a very diverse background starting out. Who were some guys you looked up to when you first started out?
As funny as it may sound, my dad was one of my biggest heroes and role models growing up, and the reason being, he was a real big guy. He was 6'4", 250 pounds, and there's nothing he couldn't do, big guy like that, and he thought I was going to be a football player and the whole deal, and he ends up marrying this chick that's 5'3" and weighs like 95 pounds, and so, the football thing didn't work out for me so well, so I took some music, and he was always a real big supporter because that was the one thing he couldn't do. You know, he was a big guy, no big muscle and that kind of thing, but he couldn't sing. So he really, really supported me. And we grew up poor, on a farm and all that. And regardless, he would drive me around the state, any kind of fair or festival or whatever that I could get into to perform and play and that kind of thing. He would take me there. It was a big supporter. And he was diagnosed with terminal cancer when I was 11 years old, which was a heartbreaking to me because we were very, very close, he was a big supporter of mine, believe me, that kind of thing. So I recorded the CD, and I set it out, and we did a benefit for him and things like that, and I would ask for donations or whatever just to raise money because he couldn't work, because he got sick and that kind of thing. And he passed away when I was 13 years old, and the last 2 months of his life, he sat there 24/7, that CD just played. And music already having been a huge passion of mine. Watch seeing that, the support that I had from him, which I already knew about, but then getting to see that, it really hit home, it taught me to, pursue my passion and my dreams because they were my passion, my dreams, and I wanted to do that, but also it kind of felt like I owed it to him, him having that much support and belief both in me, and you learn, never give up, that kind of thing,
exactly.
Follow your heart and chase your dreams, that kind of thing.
Exactly, definitely. So, obviously, you've seen just about every aspect of this business from an early age.
Sure.
So how do you feel that kind of differentiates you a little bit from, like, obviously, you're just starting out on your own, coming from the lead singer of a very famous band here in Texas, you've seen every aspect of that. Do you think that's benefited you now as you're starting on your own?
Well, I mean, I wouldn't say I've seen it all by any means. I have been doing this a long time. But the original music scene, it's much different. The Emotions is a cover band. And so there, you learn those, how to hold the attention of an audience and how to put on a live show and how to, pick songs and a set list that's going to grab their attention and keep the dance floor packed and keep, people interested in what you're doing. But then, the original music side of things, you kind of have to learn that on your own because you literally, at least I do,
you kind of write your own destiny. You know? You write the things that you feel, and the experiences that you've lived. And like I said before, you see that release on the album. You know, you'll be able to kind of follow that progression of my life and my story. And that's the message that I want to put out, and I feel have put out via my album.
Yeah, definitely. You say, your new album, you're working on some new stuff, correct?
That's right.
Awesome. And also, we just want to mention, we're going to have you perform a song just in a few seconds. But right now, we are not only live on KSUQ.com, we're also Facebook Live right now, aren't we? Tell us a little bit about this.
That's right, guys. So if you go to our Facebook page, our artist Facebook page, it's facebook.com/WillCarterBand. We are doing a live video stream of what's happening right here at the Horny Toad, and as you can see, so head over there, and you can listen to the live stream, but you can also watch on video what's actually happening here on this side of the world.
And again, if you're listening online, tell us again that website, the Facebook website.
It's facebook.com/WillCarterBand.
Awesome. So
while you're there, if you press that thumbs up, that'd be great too.
There you go.
Facebook likes.
Give us a like. That we appreciate that. So while we're listening live and watching live, would you like to play us a song?
Of course, absolutely. So, do you have a preference?
Artist choice, whatever you like. That's what we like here.
Okay, cool. So this is a song I wrote that's just about having fun. Right?
There you go.
It's called With You.
Yeah. This is the Will Carter on KSUQ.com.
Rain's flowing when the sun goes down. Country music playing in the background. Lock these bedwind news track of time. Pick a memory or two doing what we want to. It's so easy, like summer. Challenges I'm gonna take you, rules I'm gonna break you, small towns I'm gonna leave them as quick as you can. Love is gonna make it, adventures I'm gonna live it, summer is gonna be with you. It's so easy, like a summer Sunday. Empty bottles scattered all through the house. My head's knocking to the beat of the sun. Got us dancing and out of control. Bright lightning is knocking out on the door. Yeah, we are. Chances I'm gonna take it. Rules I'm gonna break it. Small towns I'm gonna leave them as quick as you can. Love is gonna make it. Adventures I'm gonna bring it. Summer is gonna be with you. It's so easy. Like a summer Sunday, yeah. Driving down the interstate, just loaded up, headed out to a place that no one knows. No one knows our name. Chances I'm gonna take it, rules I'm gonna break it, small sounds I'm gonna leave it, as quick as you can. Chances I'm gonna take it, rules I'm gonna break it. Small towns I will leave them as quick as you can. Love is gonna make it. Adventures are gonna bring it. Summer is gonna be with you. It's so easy. Yeah, it's so easy. It's so easy. Like a summer Sunday.
With you, yo.
All right, that was Will Carter on the Big Q here, live at the Horny Toad Pub and Grub. And Will, if you don't like your music, tell us where we can find it.
Well, you can definitely find it on iTunes. If you go to iTunes and type in Will Carter Band, it's there. So also Amazon and all those other online music outlet kind of places. So, or just go to Google and type Will Carter Band. But also, a good place to always start is www.willcarterband.com, because that's our main website, and from there you can not only find original music, but you can see the music video to our current single on Texas Country Radio, I Don't Know Why, and we post videos all the time of clips from live shows and acoustic gigs and things like that, and so you can see our show schedule and the bio and all that good stuff with them.
Awesome.
Or obviously come to a live show, because at live shows we've always got merch and CDs and t-shirts and all that kind of good stuff too.
Which is always the best way to do it. Meet the artist live.
That's right, we want to meet all of you, so definitely come to a live show, say hi. My bass player makes fun of me and says I'm a selfie king, but it's because I like to meet my fans and I like to meet y'all are my friends, so y'all hang out, we'll take a selfie, we'll post it on Facebook, sign an autograph, buy a t-shirt, sign that, whatever. So we do want to meet everybody.
Awesome. No shame in the selfie game. No problem with that. That's a great thing.
I don't care.
Awesome.
I have a selfie stick.
You do.
My girl brought me a selfie stick for Christmas, and it's a real thing.
obviously. And you were talking about your girlfriend, obviously a big help, filming stuff for her. Obviously, great support system. Filming right now, actually.
Absolutely. The beautiful and talented Miss Pamela Mary is behind the camera. She can double tap it. You can see it. Well, she's in a couple of those selfies anyways. But not only that, she was actually named the top female voice coach in Texas by the Texas Music News Magazine. So she's got her own thing going on. She sings harmony with us. She's my co-pilot on the radio tour, and as right now, the Facebook Live video director. So
that is awesome.
Definitely an asset.
That is great, man. Obviously, on the road, there's a lot of stuff people don't realize. There's a lot of work that goes into not just performing, even going on a simple radio tour. There's a lot of work involved.
Absolutely, man. I wouldn't call it simple. This is my first one, so I'm learning. And the cool thing is, with the whole Facebook Live thing, all my friends and family and fans are getting to learn what's all about, what it's all about and what's all involved. At the same time, I am, because it's just like they're right here with us, and that's been real cool too. Getting to see the feedback from everybody and the support, and getting to see who's watching and commenting and that kind of thing. But no, you're definitely right. There's a lot that goes into it. People think that you just get to play guitar and sing, and that in itself is something. But there's writing, and there's recording, and there's marketing, and there's music videos, and there's radio tours, and there's a lot that goes into it, for sure.
That's awesome. It's great to see, but it's not just you, it's Team Well behind.
Hey, yeah, absolutely. Like anything else, you gotta have a support group, and you gotta have a good team behind you. And I have been very, very fortunate to not only have a very talented team, all the way from the band to my radio promoter to my manager but also a huge support group, meaning my family and my friends and my fans, and a great producer, a great co-writer. There's just so many little pieces that go into it, and we're this being the first release, it's all kind of new, and it's doing really well. So it's nice to see the payoff from not only the hard work, but the good team, all the support that's behind it. And so big thanks to everybody for letting me just get to chase my passion and my dream, and to each and every one of you guys. So thank you so much.
Definitely. That's one thing, is you're definitely connected with your fans, and I think it's safe to say your fans part of Team Will too, because
absolutely.
I noticed not too long ago you posted on Facebook asking the fans directly what song they would like for the next single.
That's exactly right.
That's
exactly
great, right, man.
Eric has done his homework, ladies and gentlemen. This guy, he's got it together. So yes, that is true. We were that was week one of the radio tour. We were actually at our beach house in Padraig Island. It was terrible. But some downtime after a couple radio interviews during the day, sitting by the pool and drinking some beers, and we really do. We want to know what the fans want to hear, So we've got the EP coming out. We have a full album. We're releasing a 5-song EP, which is basically half of that. And so we've been doing that. We've been performing live and taking videos of the songs that are on the EP, because we want to hear from you guys what y'all want to hear as our next release. I don't know why it was the first release, and we'll be on the EP. So that's number one. But number two is up to you guys. We want to know what you think, not only about this one, but what you want to hear next, and that'll help steer the music that comes your way in the future. Right?
Awesome. That's great. We see a lot of artists nowadays going their own route, going the independent route. We've seen a lot of crowdsourcing nowadays, getting the fans involved, letting them be a part of the process. So it's great to see you doing the same thing, letting the fans have a voice, because they know your music, they like your music, they know your songs. So they want to see you succeed, you know, just as well. So that's awesome.
I'm a firm believer. I mean, if you don't have fans, you're nobody. I'm sorry. I don't care. I mean, the fans make you. The fans give you the ability to do this. Okay, there's a lot of people that can sing and play, and if you have no fans, you can't do it. You know what I mean? So we can't do it without you. So we want to obviously cater to what you guys want to hear. And you know, if this is the Will Carter Band, you guys are Team Will Carter Band, right?
Exactly.
And we wouldn't be able to do this if it wasn't for you guys. So this is all for you. So let us know.
Awesome. Well, speaking about all for them, how about another song?
Absolutely. Well, that's what they want to hear. So feel free to comment. Miss Pamela is watching, so she can see if you guys comment and request. But if not, I would like to. Well, how many are we going to do? That'll help me.
Two or three more.
Two or three more. Okay, cool. So there's a song we competed in the 33rd Annual Country Showdown. What that is a national country talent competition, essentially. And we competed out at the Austin County Fairgrounds in Bellevue, Texas. And we won first place with this song, and we got to open up for Mr. Aaron Watson. We got to play Billy Bob's Texas over in Fort Worth. And so I like to play that song. This song's about you're into a chick, she's into you, and maybe her parents don't approve of you. From a different side of town, I think. So it's called Wrong Side of Town.
Wrong Side of Town, Will Carter and the Big Kid. I was on your website earlier, WillCarterBand.com, correct?
That's
right? The soldier.
I was going through some of your videos, and not only is she on Team Roadrunner, behind the camera tonight, she's also, you know, pretty good on vocals, correct?
Absolutely, I mentioned earlier about her being named the top female voice coach in the state of Texas by Houston Music News Magazine. She's actually been teaching vocals for about 16 years.
Awesome.
Phenomenal following this information. So I try not to let her up here too much because it makes me look bad.
But am I correct? I hope I'm not putting my foot in my mouth here, but if they want to, they can see a video, can they not?
Absolutely.
On the website?
Absolutely, yeah. If you go to WillCarterBand.com, there's, I think, at least two acoustic videos of the two of us doing some acoustic work, and then when we do full band shows, yeah, make sure you see what we're doing.
Awesome. Definitely check out those videos on WillCarterBand.com.
I'm a big fan of Harmony. I think that sets you apart from a lot of bands. So Harmony guitar player. We're fortunate to have a very, very, very awesome band. My lead guitar player, Aaron Lesh from Brenham, Texas, he competed in a Guitar Center's Fiddler Blues competition.
Oh, wow.
And that's, if you've heard of it, every Guitar Center in the country competes. And so there were 6,500 contestants that competed in this competition, and he got first place.
Nice.
So, yeah, he's an awesome guitar player, awesome slide player. And he sings harmony as an officer to his family. So, you know, that really sets you apart when you have that three-part harmony sound. And then the whole band's full of front people, so, you know, I mean, our drummer is a big 6'5" guy with long, dark hair, and he's a front man himself. Our bass player is a front man, our guitar player is a front man, and so, it's, like I said, I love the high-energy shows, you know, and the band's definitely caters towards that, for sure.
Yeah, and that's the thing about Texas music nowadays is, you know, it's not just Texas country anymore. There's genres, and there's subgenres of subgenres of subgenres. Just, in a nutshell, if we go to a Will Carter Band show, what are we going to see?
Man, you're going to see a little bit of everything. That's the thing, you know. I grew up sitting on a tractor singing back on the country and digging country music. And then, you know, listening to Chris LeDoux on cassette tape with my dad doing old school stuff. And then got a little older and got into more of the rocked up stuff. I like our energy. I like, you know, getting more rocked up kind of sound. And then, you know, the guitar player plays rock and Delta blues, you know, and the bass player plays jazz and rock, and the drummer plays country and rock, and I mean, so we all have a lot of different influences, you know, and you definitely see that in a lot of shows. I mean, you know, if we do a cover, we'll do, you know, Waylon Jennings, Are You Sure Hank, you know, and this is the album that they're straight to you, you know, and when we do it, it's totally different, you know, it's a lot of fun, you know, so if you're, you come to a live show, be ready to throw down another part of the show.
Well, I gotta ask, you know, being from a small town, we've seen our scene share of live music here, and it's surprising for a smaller town like this, but, you know, all of you road musicians, I gotta ask, what is the most common or weirdest cover you've been asked to play at a live show?
Most common or weirdest? Most common is Freebird.
Of course, of course. Don't be that guy.
Alabama. We play Stephen Alabama, but we don't do Freebird. Oh, we have. Now that one's real common. As far as weird goes, you know, I wouldn't say that's weird. I'm a huge. It's funny about the cover music is, you know, it depends, you know, where you're at, right? But, you know, I've played so many different venues, and so many different styles, and because our band does have those different influences, we can get away with playing a venue that's more rock than, you know, a lot of bands. You know, there's a lot of venues I play where we play that don't have country bands other than us. And so, you know, we'll literally get requests for things like Alice in Chains, because that's what they play at that bar. So, you never know.
Awesome. You know, like you said earlier, Ron Side of Town, it won first place at the Country Showdown, the 33rd Country Showdown. And it actually charted on the national charts, is that correct?
That's right. So it charted number 3 on national radio, local national radio station called E-Radio Nashville as well. It reached number 3 for 2 or 3 weeks.
Awesome.
In fact, I actually released the current single I got out right now, I don't know why, and, to the same area out there in Nashville. And we played CMA Festival in Nashville for the last couple of years, and go up there now with the writing sessions, and Taylor Swift's manager Rick Barker put on
and an artist development kind of seminar deal. So we go through and you're learning experience kind of stuff or whatever. Just in the being up there, you know, there's a lot of stuff out there. Amazing. So it's like Austin, Texas. And there's always a lot of things going on. I can see the mess of people. So anyway, that's kind of, and I don't know why I actually charted number one. So we brought it up to Texas and released it here. I'm super excited about the success we've had already so far, and I'm real curious to see how well we do here in the hometown.
That's great. You know, we gotta take ownership of our Texas artists, and sometimes in the scene, we become almost snobbish with it sometimes. Talk a little bit about, you know, branching out and doing both Texas and the Nashville scene, because I think it's a great idea. Why keep it just in one place when we can share it with the entire world, you know?
Well, what's cool about Texas and Texas music is that we have our own genre.
Yeah.
We have created our own genre of music, and that is awesome. We've got people all around the country that are trying to mimic they're trying to play Texas country. And we essentially created our own genre, and how cool is that, right?
Yeah.
Texas is the greatest state in America, and we can practically be our own country. So I feel like it kind of lines right up with each other, and I think it's awesome. But to me, I don't really know how to say what it's like to be attacking a Texas or putting out Texas music or putting out Nashville music or whatever. Man, I like to say a lot of music songs, okay? I like one kind of music. I like good music.
There you go.
I don't care what genre you want to call it. I just like good music. And so I write what I feel and what I think sounds good. And I live in Texas, and I grew up listening to Texas country, and I think it's awesome that we have our own genre, and I feel honored and obliged to be a part of it, be one of those guys that's got a song of a Texas country genre, to call yourself a Texas country artist, you know.
Yeah.
That means a lot to me. At the same time, I want, you know, my music to be heard by everybody, and so if people in Oklahoma like it, or people in Wisconsin like it, then great. If they don't, then great. You know what I mean?
There you go. Well, since we're talking about good music, you want to play us another one?
Absolutely. So this is another one of the songs that we were considering possibly being the next release with the input of our fans. This is a song that means it's close to home to me because I got to play this song at my little sister's wedding. She got married just about 4 weeks ago now. And this song's played right away. And so that means a lot to me. Her and I are real close. If you're watching, if you're listening, Pam Carter and all Pamela Garcia. So I'm still getting used to it. Just the other day, changed her name on my phone from Pam Carter to Pamela Garcia. Anyways, love you, and this is for you. And congratulations to you and Mr. Garcia. This song's called Turn.
This is Will Carter on KS's YouTube content.
Steal
wide awake. My soul and I'm stuck in the same way. Scarred in a lover's ways. She can have me.
Straight to Brenham, Texas and headline Mayfest, which is the largest German festival in the country, and we're expecting about 10,000 people, and we're getting to headline that, so huge honor, definitely going to be a good time.
Awesome. And again, we're broadcasting live here on Facebook.
Facebook.com/Will Carter Band,
correct?
That's right, Facebook.com/Will Carter Band.
What about other social media, where are you at?
So if you can remember Will Carter Band, you got it under control. You just have to remember Will Carter Band. So Facebook.com/Will Carter Band, Twitter.com/Will Carter Band, Instagram.com/Will Carter Band, YouTube.com/Will Carter Band, all of them. So just remember Will Carter Band, you got to go.
Awesome. Make sure everyone request the current single, I Don't Know Why. Call all your radio stations. Make sure you get that in. And I want to thank you for coming out here tonight. You want to take us out with one more tonight?
Let's do the single.
There we go.
I like it.
There we go. This is I Don't Know Why, correct? Which people can get on iTunes. And
that's right. Go to iTunes. Type in Will Carter Band. I Don't Know Why. You can see the music video to it on our website, willcarterband.com. And that music video was featured as the video of the week for 3 or 4 weeks straight on the Texas Regional Radio Report website, which is super cool. Obviously, I'm a little partial to it. So yeah, check the music video out if you can. And we're thank you guys for the support. This is our first release, it's a single, and we're currently at number 47 on the Texas charts. So thank you guys so much. I wrote this song about hanging out with a chick that you really dig and not wanting to call it a night. So I don't know why.
good bell, didn't leave you wanting more. No need to rest, Lord, now I've been around getting crazy. Oh, baby, I don't know why we gotta say goodbye. Can we just wait until the sunrise? And nobody's waiting on me. Got no other feet to shut down the day. I don't know why. You gave me a ring. You told me that you can't wait to do it all over again. I want to see you in the moonlight. Follow the stars until they're out of sight. Don't call it a night, call it what you like. Together, you could get better. Wait until the sunrise. Nobody's waiting on me. Got nowhere to be. Shutting down the lake. I don't know why. Yeah, you got me where I want you, but it don't make sense. I don't know why.
Request that song. Request I Don't Know Why. Will, thank you again so much for coming out here.
Thank you guys.
Anything you want to leave our fans with here tonight?
Hey, I just want to say thanks for everybody for hanging out with us this long and putting up with us and all this craziness. And a big shout out, big thank you to the Horny Toe Club and Girl for having us out, guys. Thank you guys for listening. Thank y'all for clapping. Thank y'all for cheering. And we appreciate you guys, so we'll see y'all next time.
Also, one more time before we head out, tell us where we can find you.
www.willcarterband.com and facebook.com/willcarterband. That's the place.
Awesome. You've been listening to Will Carter here at the Horny Toad Pub and Grub here in Slidere, Texas. Great treat. Thank you so much, Will, for coming out tonight. That's going to do it here for us here at the Horny Toad Pub and Grub. Be sure to keep listening to that great music coming up all night long. You've been listening to KSUZQ.com, the Big Q. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.